In this video, we'll walk you through the concepts of object-oriented programming. Before diving into the details of how Python implements object-oriented programming techniques, let's take a quick refresher of some object-oriented programming principles. In the first place, let's start with some of the reasons and motivations for using object-oriented programming. Object-oriented programming is a very important aspect of modern programming languages. The basic principles of object-oriented programming are relatively easy to learn. Before object-oriented programming, those days, languages like C, Pascal, Fortran were in use. These were called as procedural programming language. In these languages, programmers use procedure or function to perform a task while developing a software. In procedural programming, a program is divided into a set of functions. Function 1, function 2, function 3, like this. Set of functions. So we have data stored in a bunch of variables and functions that operate. And let's say I have x, y variable. These functions operate on a data. This type of programming is very simple and straightforward. But when the program logic becomes complex, it'll end up with the bunch of functions that are all over the place. You might land up copying and pasting lines of code again and again. If you have to make a change to one function and then several other functions break because it has so much interdependencies between all those functions, it becomes problematic. To solve this problem, object-oriented program came into play. In object-oriented program, we combine a group of related variables and methods into a single unit. Next, functional programming. It provides the advantages like efficiency and lazy evaluation, nested functions, parallel programming. It allows for very modular and clean code that all works together in harmony. Next, we'll see what is declarative programming paradigm. So in this case, it expresses the logic of a computation without describing its control flow. The example for declarative programming paradigms are, you know, the SQL or Prolog. Prolog used in artificial intelligence applications. Now let us proceed with understanding the concepts of object-oriented programming. Before we proceed with understanding the object-oriented concepts, let us see what are the terms that are there in object-oriented programming. We have something called class, methods, attributes, object, inheritance. Class is a blueprint for creating objects of a particular type. And methods in class, if you define a function, we call that as a method. Attributes are variables which holds the data that are part of a class. An object is a specific instance of a class. Inheritance, we'll discuss about inheritance in the later videos. Now let's try to understand what is a class. Unlike procedural programming language, where the main emphasis on functions, whereas in object-oriented programming, class and objects are the main aspects. Now we will see what is a class and what is an object and how to create them. So a class is a blueprint or template from which objects are created. It is a logical entity. It allows data and methods to be grouped together. If you look at here, the class name is bank account. The class bank account has a group of both the methods and attributes. In the attributes also called as properties. These attributes hold the data in it. In Python, there is a special method called init. When you define an object, the init method will be invoked automatically. And please note that that a class cannot have more than one constructors. Next we'll see what is an object. Object is created from the class. It is an instance of a class. It holds, you know, that holds data in its variables. Each object must be a member of a particular class. In this case, fruit is a class, and the apple, orange, mango are the member of this class. Now let us go ahead and see how to create a simple class in PyCharm. So I'm going to create a class by the name of bank account. To create a class, we need to use the keyword class followed by the class name. Here the class is the keyword and bank account is the class name. The class name can be anything. In the second line, I specify a statement by the name of pass. So the class bank account is an empty class, because in this class I did not specify the data and functionality. Next, in the main function, I'll be creating an object. Let's say I'm going to create an object by the name of AC. To create an object, we need to specify the class name followed by the parenthesis. Now I save this and execute it. We can see that the object got created. So what it tells, the object AC belongs to class bank account, is created in the main, and it is saved in this memory location. In the subsequent video, we'll delve deeper into the classes and objects.